6 and 11.
David was talking a few minutes ago about his plans to go and help get that house ready for the missionaries coming to town. The truth is there are so many different ways that you can give back in this wonderful community that we call home. Sophie Moore has a frontline seat in that effort each and every day. She's with the Chattanooga Area Food Bank, and she joins us this morning. Good to see you.
Good morning. Thanks for having us.
I'm glad to have you. So we're going to talk still about contributions that you could always benefit from at the food bank, but you're kind of excited because this morning you can talk about a monetary amount that you're in a position to kind of give away. Is that a fair way to put it, Sophie?
Well, we're not giving it away. Actually, the federal government states is helping families whose kids were on free and reduced meals who didn't get to receive them this spring when schools closed. So each state that serves, Southeast Tennessee, Northwest Georgia, each state's administering its own program called Pandemic Electronic Benefits Transfer. If your child is enrolled in reintroduced school lunch and you receive SNAP, which you called food stamps, you're going to receive $256.50 per child automatically on your EBT card to replace lost meals in the spring. But if your child is enrolled in free and reduced school meals and you're not participating in SNAP, you have to apply for funding. It's very generous, like I said, $256.50. So it's really important that those parents whose kids are enrolled in free and reduced school lunch but are not receiving SNAP sign up for it. You can go to our website, it'll pop up on our homepage, and it'll take you for more information.
Okay, so does that mean then if your circumstances maybe changed because perhaps you were employed and weren't needing the benefits back in March, April, or May, but now things have changed for you, that's where this application process comes into play?
No, this is actually for anyone whose child was enrolled in free and reduced school lunch in the spring. So if your child was enrolled in free and reduced school lunch in the spring, and of course the schools were closed, so your kids didn't get those meals, you're eligible to receive $256 one time per child that you have.
Okay.
So definitely our website to learn more. However, if you've lost your job, if your hours have been cut, if your financial situation is different, we can actually help you enroll in SNAP. So any questions about SNAP or about the pandemic EBT program, we have a coordinator who will help enroll you. Just visit our website, chatfoodbank.org.
Okay. In early COVID days, one of the stories that was national was the fact that here you had these farmers with all this food to deliver to market and restaurants, and there was nowhere to take the food. The food bank has stepped in to find a way to utilize that food as well. Is that kind of it?
You know, this is a really interesting program. So the federal government stepped in and rescued this food and helped farmers subsidies. But has to go somewhere because we have a track record of being able to distribute food quickly to a lot of people. Food banks across the country are working as regional coordination agencies. Essentially, we're working with distributors in our area, the same people that deliver food to restaurants and, you know, grocery stores, and that food's getting redirected into the hands of nonprofits. So we have helped coordinate the distribution of almost 900,000 pounds of really high quality, the same kind of food that you would get when you go out to eat, if you go on a cruise ship. If you were to go to any of these venues that had to close during the pandemic, that's a whole new food resource for our region now. No questions asked, working across our region to just get more nutritious food into the hands of people who need it.
Okay, so does that mean, Sophie, that when people come to the food bank to get the boxes that you're able to generously provide, included in that are some of these foods, or are these something that you specifically request?
This is it's a completely different, completely new program. So we're working with agencies that we haven't necessarily worked with in this capacity before. So Chambliss Center for Children, instead of going through us and having to get food delivered from our warehouse or come pick it up, we're with organizations like TNT Produce and saying this organization needs to pass out food to their people. Same thing with Chattanooga Kidney Centers. They essentially are going directly to the source. We're kind of cutting out the middle and essentially helping identify the organizations that need it the most. And then that food gets delivered straight to them very fresh, very high quality.
I gotcha. Okay, so let me go ahead and show people the information where they can always reach out, whether they're in a position to give to the food bank's efforts, or if perhaps you are someone who needs the benefits of all that the food bank has to offer. You can always give them a call at 622-1800. Their office is there on Curtain Pole Road off Amnicola, and online it's chatfoodbank.org. If you'll go there, you can learn more about the SNAP program and how to get enrolled. Thank you so much, Sophie.
Thank you.
You love where you live and know you're not ready for a move. Mobility at Home can build